Welcome everybody to another video from the Garish Grackle. Today I'll be doing the heartstrings. Painted with oil on canvas, the dimensions are 114 by 146 centimeters. It was completed in Belgium in 1960, which belongs to Magritte's later period and is now a part of a private collection. There is very little, in fact close to nothing, that I could find regarding this piece in all of my research. So I will provide an explanation as to why this stands as one of my favorites and the meaning that resounds for me when I look at this piece. Strangely enough, but the first thing that came to my mind was the Nevada desert in America and the space program of the 1960s. I'm going to focus on the glass, that there is something sublime about the glass. I imagine driving along a long American highway, and there is this inexplicable resplendence that shimmers in the corner of my eye, hinting at some beautiful, some high, perfect structure that my lowbrow self could only ever catch glimpses of. The refractions of this pristine something reflects in and out of the pupils of my eye, a brilliance of pure sunlight somehow made solid. And deep in a space of my subconscious, that store of hundreds of thousands of years of collective memory, I see the strange phenomena, clear, brilliant, unapologetic, stark, and uncompromising, inviting me yet again to join it on this journey. For me, Magritte is in tune with providing questions to the mysteries of our universe. Here is a man whose genuine curiosity is insatiable, but there is far more to that incessant inquiry of this mind. Magritte was a humanist and existentialist of the highest order. He transports every participant who comes into contact with his work to a realm defined by a new exciting reality. He is like a doctor to the aforementioned crisis of consciousness that the 20th century was suffocating with. And I am so deeply moved by the sincerity that he puts into all of his pieces. The 21st century is equally plagued with a resounding strangulation of self. Who amongst us is stepping up and taking the tools of the past 6,000 years of recorded history and prescribing that desperately needed medicine to cure the existentialist crisis deadening us today? Engaging in Magritte's work was like dipping my soul into the fabled baths of Hebe. It reintroduced a hope for an untouched sanctuary and provided a delicate, fragile root there. This is the goal of a good artist, to illuminate the structures of the real world by capturing that momentary beauty. Yet Magritte's invitation to a heightened state of living is timeless. Like the turning of the Castle of Pyrenees, I feel, given half the chance, it would turn unendingly, going further and further. It would be up to us to accept and jump fearlessly on board, allowing the confines of our present state of accepted reality to disintegrate. This is where the shock and fear of the new only ever allows glimpses into that nirvana-like existence. So I decided that, look, it's not for me to just flippantly put up René Magritte. I wanted people who were looking or hoping to decipher the enigmatic qualities of his work to find help in this, with this channel, maybe assist them or help better illuminate. But from the Garish Grackle, I hope you have a lovely day. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and goodbye.